Hi everyone, welcome to object oriented programming class. Now we see the topic on types of exception handling in Java. Please use headphone for better audio quality. Then exception handling can be classified into two types. First one, default exception handling or predefined exception using multiple catch statement. Then user defined custom exception handling. The first one is system defined, second one user defined. Okay, the default exception handling: when an exception occurs during the execution of the program, the JVM, Java Virtual Machine, check whether any user defined exception handling mechanism is defined in that program or not. If no such user defined exception handling mechanism is present, the JVM will automatically make use of the default exception handling mechanism for reporting the exception. For example, consider the same exception, class test1, public static void main, string argument, valid statement, int I equal to 1, j equal to 0, system.out.println, I divided by j. Here automatically divide by 0 error exception raised. Okay, first of all, the here JVM check the any user defined mechanism is available or not. Here no user defined mechanism is available. By default, system call the system defined mechanism and display the error message in the common error message, that is java.lang.arithmeticexception divide by 0 error at line number 6. Exception handling using multiple catch. Multiple catch means we have to use more than one catch block, one try block followed by more than one catch blocks. So syntax for the same, here the try block is available. The try block means it contains set of statements. The try block check whether the exception is raised or not. If the exception is raised, control transfer to the any one of the catch block, then catch exception type 1 parameter, exception type 2 parameter, and exception type n set of parameter. In this syntax, the try keyword is followed by a set of catch blocks. If an exception occurs during the execution of the statement in try block, an object of that exception will immediately generated. That means, for example, divided by 0 error, number format exception, class not support exception, etc. In such cases, the remaining statement in the try block will be skipped and the control will move to the first catch block. Each catch block is defined to tackle one type of exception. Catch block begins with the catch statement, which resembles a method definition. A single parameter, which is reference to the exception object generator, is passed to the catch statement. If the type of the exception object matches the type of the catch block parameter, then the control will enter into the catch block and all the statements in that block will be executed. On the other hand, if the type of the exception object does not match the type of the catch block parameter, then the remaining catch blocks will be examined in their order of presence. If no match found, then JVM will invoke the default exception handling mechanism. That means JVM check all the catch blocks, but no match found is there, the control transfer to the default exception handling mechanism. Okay, here we'll consider one example. Import space java.util.asterisk, class pre, valid statement, public static void main, no problem, int a comma b comma c, scanner command, no problem, a is equal to s dot next in, b is equal to s dot next in. You are getting the inputs for a, both a and b. In the try block, c is equal to a divided by b. Here system.out.println, here for next first catch is array index out of bounds exception, space system.out argument is required, then catch block number format, second catch block for the number format exception class, then third catch block is a arithmetic exception. In the arithmetic exception, system.out.println enter the denominator value as non-zero value, b is equal to next in, c is equal to a to b, system.out.println. Next one, first close curly brace for public static void main closing, second close curly brace for class closing. Next I am going to run the first time I am going to run the program java space pre. Here the first input equal to 20, second input equal to 0, then automatically inside the try block exception is raised. So exception raised in the third statement, c is equal to a divided by b, 20 divided by 0, exception is raised, generated. Then it stopped the current execution, control transfer to the catch block. Go to the first catch block, here the exception is divided by 0, that is arithmetic exception. First check the catch block, array index out of bounds exception, not matched. Then second catch, number format exception, not matched. Third one, catch arithmetic exception. So here the object reference as well as catch reference both are same. then control transports the third catch block. Here the system.out.println, that means after entering the catch block, it executes all the statement in the catch block. System.out.println, enter the denominator value as non-zero value. So it display the message, enter the denominator value as non-zero value, b equal to s.nextint. Now we are going to give the input for the second input, b equal to 10. Next, c is equal to a 20 divided by 10, answer equal to 2. System.out.println c means it prints the value 2. So, no problem. Second time, I am going to execute the same program for Java PRE. The first input 20, second input 0. So, automatically in the try block, exception tries to in the statement c is equal to a divided by b. So, control transfer to the catch, third catch block, that is enter the denominator value as non-zero value. Again, if the user enter the same value 0 means, again the user enter the 0 value, c is equal to a divided by b. So 20 divided by 0, again the exception is raised. Again the same exception raised, that exception is arithmetic exception divided by 0 error. Hereafter there is no catch block is available. So automatically JVM check the remaining user defined exception not available. So by default JVM control transfer to the default exception handling mechanism and display the message arith java.language.arithmetic exception divided by 0 error in the line number 29. Okay. Next one program. The same program. Same program, only one small changes. That means that is try block same, first catch block same, second catch block same, third catch block catch only changes in this third catch block. Here in the third catch block, arithmetic exception AE, enter the denominator value as non-zero value, b equal to next in. Here I am going to use the one while loop. That while loop perform, while loop will be executed until the b not equal to zero. That means if I want to perform the division operation, and that means this, the program definitely did the division operation first. Okay, then next one, while b equal to 0, system.out.println, enter the non-zero value, b.nextint. Okay, c is equal to a dot b, system dot, here the first run, I am going to run the program, 20 and 0, in the try block, c is equal to 20 divided by 0, exception tries. Check the first catch block not matched, second catch block not matched, third catch block matched. Control transfer to the third catch block, enter the denominator value as non-zero value. Again, b equal to s dot next, again I am entering the zero value. Enter the same zero value. Next, again the while loop asks the input, enter the non-zero value. Again, I am enter the zero value. Then again, check the same condition, enter the non-zero value. Now my value equal to 4. That means b value equal to 4 means exit from the while loop. Then c is equal to a divided by b, 20 divided by 4 equal to 5. So system.out.println c means it prints the value 5. That is 20 divided by 4 equal to answer equal to 5. So the user write any statement in the catch block. If you want to execute the program means you have to write the coding for that logic. Okay. Catch block, the user write any statements. Okay, no problem. The next one. Class import space java.util.assist, class user valid statement, public static void main string argument, int a scanner command valid statement, in the try block, one try block, one catch block is there, system.out.println, enter the whole number, a equal to s.nextint, system.out.println, entered value is plus a, that means the input a value of the a will be printed here, catch number format exception n, system.out.println, type a whole number. Okay. Next one, I am going to run the program. First run, Java space user, enter the whole number. My input equal to 25. My input equal to 25 means s.next integer, enter the whole number, 25 input, a equal to 25, that is s.next integer. The 25 value is converted to integer value, no problem. The entered value is 25, no error. Finish. Second time, I am going to execute the same program. Enter the whole number. My input equal to 12.5. Here the 12.5 not accommodated with the integer data types because 12.5 is a double value. Now we are packing the value in the integer. That means exception raised. That means third line not executed. That is in the second line a equal to s dot next integer. Exception raised in the second line. It skipped the third line. Then control transfer to the catch block. That error is number format exception. That means you are asking the integer input, but the user give the double input. That is number format exception, matching with the number format exception catch block, and display the message type a whole number. Okay. The next one, finally block. So one more block is available in the try catch block. That is finally block. Its syntax is try block. followed by set of catch block, catch 1, catch 2, up to catch n. Then final ones, finally open curly brace, set of statements and close curly brace. Here, at the end of the every try catch block, we have the finally block. That is, finally block should be defined at the end of the catch block, okay? The JVM ensured that the statement placed in the finally block are executed whether or not an exception occurs. That means whether the exception is occurred or not, I want to execute all the statement in the finally block means we should define the final block, okay? If no exception occurs during the execution of the try block, the finally block is also executed. Example program, imports dot utl dot asterisk, no problem, class user, public static void main, valid statement, int a, scanner spaces equal to new scanner system dot in, try block, system dot out dot println, enter the whole number, a is equal to s dot next integer, entered value equal to a, then catch block, catch number format exception, type a whole number, finally system dot out dot println, this is finally block, okay, no problem. First time I am going to execute the program, Java user, enter the whole number 25.5. 25.5 means 25.5 is a double value, but the program expecting the integer input. So packing is, that is number format exception is erased. That means it skipped the third line, control transfer to the catch block, that is the catch number format exception, type the whole number message displayed. After that, finally block will be executed. This is finally block. The second time I am going to run the same program, enter the whole number 35, so 35 means no error, so a equal to 35, entered value is 35, that is no exception is occurred, so control transfer to the finally block and execute all the statement, that is this is finally block. That means whether the exception is raised or not, the finally, that is the statements in the finally block will be executed. Now conclude the session. We studied about the system default exception handling mechanism. Thanks for watching. Thank you.